Yes, good morning. We're walking into one of the subdivisions of one of our YWAM friends who has a church planted in here. And from our understanding, he's in a pretty flooded area. So we're just going in and checking out the situation. People are already starting to rebuild their houses on the outside here. And okay, this is one of the schools in the area, temporarily converted into an evacuation center. We're going to leave the main road now and go inside. We're only able to walk or take these little boats. This is Bernard. We were DTS classmates, DTS, Discipleship Training School classmates in 1988, and he has started a church in here.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, we rented a little boat now. It's taking us into the interior. Here's a Bible Baptist church. Schedule of services. Hey kids, come on, staff. Yeah. There's a former basketball court, now swimming pool. So I guess we've heard that most of the people at the evacuation center are from this interior housing because they just can't come back to their houses yet. Of course, there's no bathrooms in here, so you just go bathroom straight into the water or put it in a plastic bag and toss it somewhere. So for sure this water is big time bacteria. It smells like a sewer now. It's been 2 weeks now, actually. Day 13. Hey, como esta? Laundry? We're approaching a basketball court here, which is now an Olympic swimming stadium. Hello.
Hello.
Nice boat. These guys here are delivering drinking water to some houses down the street. Business as usual over there. Basic groceries and rice. And she's well, I got a lot of people down there. A lot of. Hi, como esta? How's business today?
I so hard to have business today because of the flood.
Hey, como esta?
Hi.
Hey, como esta? Follow Jesus, huh? Every day. Jesus is coming back soon, huh? The end is near. Okay, this is Pastor Bernard, of my former discipleship training school classmate, and we're now in this church. What would you like to say to everybody out there?
Thank you so much for being with us, my brother Mitch, and also the YWAMer. Thank you for helping us, not only in Mitch, but in prayer. And that's all. Thank you very much.
Right. Well, we've been told that about 150 people will sleep here every night in the church. And then they will go out during the day back to their homes or go to relief or lines or whatever. And so they've been preaching every night in the church here, having special services when everybody is here sleeping. Every morning they are preparing food, we've been told. Over here in the assistant pastor's house lives here. They prepare a large breakfast and then they feed about 200 children, according to him, every morning. And this afternoon, we're going to be going into a new isolated interior area, simply taking basic relief items into that area where I guess the water is supposed to be chest high still.
Okay.
We're setting up some chairs right now, 75 chairs, waiting for the relief goods to arrive. We've got two of our SOE, one of our SOE students and one of our staff are preparing it now on the outside, and they'll be arriving soon, and then the families will be allowed to come into the building, and then we will preach to them first, and then distribute the goods, and then they will leave. So Fidel, our School of Evangelism staff, and Pastor Bernard, they're going to go now and pick up the goods, the 75 packages, which they will rendezvous with our other part of the team up on the main road where I parked my car, and then bring it back with them.
This is a box of biscuits here. Runs about $6 a box. It's totally full of crackers, but that's there's a lot of meals in there, really. So you can really, it's a good little gift bucket to give to a family for all of those missed meals. You can survive off of biscuits and bottled water. Of course, a can of baby milk. Baby powder milk is about $7 a can, and that's good for a couple weeks. Well, yeah, maybe 2 weeks if you're disciplined.
Okay, here's the arrival of those 75 packages. Here's a sample of a care package. We've got mosquito repellent. We've got the napkins for the ladies. We've got dishwashing soap, dishwashing sponge. Looks like some shampoo in there, some toothpaste, some alcohol for taking a bath, alcohol-type baths, and some laundry soap. And that's it. I don't. So there's no food items for this handout. Just some supplies for the house, for your everyday needs.
And so we believe that through the storm, God wants us to learn to hear His voice through the storm.
At naniniwala kami na pinayagan ng Panginoon na magkaroon ng bagyo na nangyari ngayon dito upang sa ganoon marinig natin ang kanyang boses, makuha natin.
Okay, 1 to 10, come forward first, and they're served, and then 11.
Hey, how's business? Hey, ¿cómo está? Hey, kid.
Hey.
Praise the Lord. Hey, guys.
Everybody's swimming on the national highway.
Yeah. Masaya tayo!
Follow Jesus every day.
Huh?
Yeah! Follow Jesus every day.
Yeah!
This is the stuff that was just given from Sumalong Baptist Church. Okay, Bernard's church has a little outreach here that they've pioneered. On Sundays they come here. This is the house they used to have their Bible study in, which used to be here. And then the flood and the shifting shifted everything here. We're actually walking on garbage, and it's floating. Where are you going to meet now? Now that there's no house, what's your next plan? The next street is another building. Where you can meet there, a building. Okay, that's good.
So we have a place there.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
We bought it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So the church bought another property there.
Yeah.